Good morning students. As discussed in pre-learning video, today we are going to learn how to copy and move content from one cell to another cell and also how to merge and wrap text present inside the cell and also how to align text, what are all the various alignment options and then insertion and deletion of rows, columns and cell. So this is what the content for the session. Listen carefully. So first I am going to tell you how to copy and move the text. Hope you had better understanding of these two terms earlier in your early grades, because in your early grade you learned Microsoft Word. Yes, so in Microsoft Word itself we learned copying, moving and also table. You may have experience in table in MS Word. So in table is same as the Excel sheet worksheet. Yes, Excel sheet worksheet is again having table only. Okay, so in table we learned how to insert a row, column, etc., etc. The same is available in Microsoft Excel also. So the content will not be new to you. So copy means creating duplicate entries. Moving means you are actually shifting the content from one location to another location. So this is what the difference between copying and moving. So for doing copying we should use the shortcut keys Ctrl plus C and Ctrl plus V, and for moving a content you should use the shortcut keys Ctrl plus X and Ctrl plus V. And if you don't want to use shortcut keys, what you can do means, see here under home tab we are having clipboard group. And in this clipboard group, the options for cut, copy and paste, everything is available. So by using this group, we can do copy and move. Are you ready? Now see, I am taking one source data of sales details. Okay, now I want to copy this entire table. Now it is my wish, whatever I want to copy. So first I have to decide on whatever I want to copy. Now see, I just want to copy the entire table. So what I can do means, so last session we discussed how to select the specific range of cells using mouse and keyboard. Now I am selecting the specific range of cells using mouse. So simply click drag and drop to the last cell. Okay, so now I selected all the things. So now I am going to copy the content. Copy means duplicating. The source content will also be available and the destination content also be available. It is like you are taking Xerox copies, yes, which is same as this. So what you have to do, you should click copy and now the content is copied. So next step is you have to decide on location, destination location, whether you want to copy the content in the same worksheet or you want to copy it in different worksheet. So now see, I want to copy the content to another sheet. So I have clicked the new sheet. Now I just select the cell wherever I want to. Now I just simply copied the cell. So now I am going to give. Okay. So in this way you can copy the content present in one cell to another cell. Now actually I have copied the content from one worksheet to another worksheet. This is one way. But now see here. Here instead of entire content, if you want to select, see, I just want these three persons or three customers information alone. So what you have to do, you have to select the same and wherever you want to place these content, simply place the cell and give Ctrl plus V. So in this way, by using shortcut key also, you can do copying. So this is for copying. Next, moving. Moving is actually shifting the content from one place to another place. See here. Now I just don't want these three customers details to be present here. Instead I want to add it at the end. So I just want to shift the place. So what you have to do, first select the required cell and go to home tab, click cut. So after giving cut, place the cursor wherever you want to move. Okay. So at last you want to move means keep the cursor accordingly and give Ctrl plus V or use paste command in home group. Now the content is shifted to last. Now go to the initial location. What may be there? Blank cells. See, the blank cells will be available here. Now I just for making continuity, I just Control V. See here. Now I have, with the help of move operation, I just moved the table and I have edited accordingly. So this is what the difference between copying and moving. Next, I am going to tell you how to merge the cells. So what is merge? Merge means combining two or more cells. For example, now I have the table, but I don't have any headings here. So now I just want to use headings. So heading to this table. So for giving a heading, I just want to merge all these five cells. So first step is you select all the five cells, go to home tab. Under home tab, we are having group called alignment. Please follow my mouse, alignment group. And in this alignment group, we are having option called merge and center. So simply click on it. See the change on the screen? Yes, now the table is merged. I just want to give a product sales details. Now what you can do? By using formatting option, you can format this heading. See, last session we learned formatting cells. You can change the font title and you can change the font size. Bold, you can give bold as it is a heading bold. You can also give color. You can give border and also shading options. Okay, so these are all the various ways you can do formatting for your content. Okay, first select everything and then apply all. See the change? You can give bold and you can also change the font size. So now it is looking nice. Yes, so in this way you can do merge. And next one is wrap text. Wrap text is nothing but you can wrap a long text into multiple lines. For example, see BOTTM customer, and he is having some other name. So see here, now after typing you couldn't see few portions in your text as the cell column is, cell size is very small. So now what I can do means I can wrap this text to multiple lines. So for that, go to home tab, alignment group. You are having option called wrap text. If you click on it, see the change, the long text is now converted to multiple lines. Okay, if you want to change the long text to multiple lines, you can apply wrap text. Next is insert and deleting options. So for example, see here I'm having 279 records, but in between, after 10th row or after 11th row, after 12th row, if I want to, sometimes I need to add some details of a specific customers. So in that situation, what I have to do? I have to insert new rows here. So for insertion, there are many ways. See here, what you can do means, if you select this, for example, if you insert 12th row for some other customer, what you can do means, you can simply select the 12th row and right click, see here you will get a insert. So if you give insert, the 12th row will be inserted. New row will be inserted. Now you can add details. Okay. If you don't want, so again go and give delete. So in this way you can insert row. If you want to insert column, what you can do? Place, insert left you can. If you give, the column will be inserted to the left hand side. So what, as per your wish, you have to choose, place the cursor. So this is one way, and we are having special group. See, under home tab we are having group called cells. So by using this you can insert cells. So see, if you click on insert cells, if you give shift cells down and shift cells right, so these two are for inserting cells, and this is to insert entire row. Now see the change, and now my current cursor is in 16th row. Now if I'm giving entire row, see, the 16th row will get a new insert row, new row. And similar way, you can also insert columns. See, insert entire column. So now the cursor is in, sorry, place the cursor accordingly so that you can feel the change. So now I want to insert entire column. See the change? So left hand side, the entire column will be added. So in this way, you can insert row and column to your Excel sheet, and also You can use this insert seed rows again to insert a row, again to insert column, and insert seed will insert a new worksheet for you. Okay, and here see here delete. So as same as delete cells, we have shift cells left up for deleting a cell, and this is to delete an entire row, this is to select entire column. Okay, so in this way you can do insertion and deletion for cells, rows and also columns. Okay children, now in this session you learnt how to work with copying, moving, merging, wrapping and inserting and deleting cells and rows, cells, rows and columns. We will discuss more about formulas in next session. Thank you children.